All right, what's going on, family? Welcome to a brand new episode of the Tariq Elite Show right here live on Ustream. I'm chilling, ready to chop up some good game. I got my ginger beer while I'm chopping it up. Y'all know I love my Jamaican ginger beers. Ah, woo! Non-alcoholic, by the way. So, we're here. It's Sunday night. And I'm ready to make it do what it do. What's up, all the ladies in the room? I feel a female spirit in the room tonight. Or it might be some bitch-ass niggas. But I feel a female spirit up in the room. Oh, yeah, a lot of folks are loving the new shirts, by the way. These are the new shirts available at TariqElite.com. These shirts are called Crucifixion. These are the new shirts right here. Bam. Go get yours. We got them in black. We got them in brown. From small to 3X. All the big players and all the petite people is unisex for men and women. You can get that at Tariq, T-A-R-I-Q, elite.com. People are loving these new shirts. Get that at TariqElite.com. All right? What's up? You from Georgia in the Georgia backwoods? What's up, MJG Music? That's what's up. The inspiration behind the shirts, man, this speaks to what's happening today. Melanoid men and women were being crucified out here for the religion of white supremacy. That's the meaning behind this shirt. A lot of folks are like, who is that? Is that Jesus? People are like, the shirt's supposed to mean Jesus was black. Nigga, the shirt, it has a lot of different meanings, but the shirt is you. If you are a melanoid person, the shirt is you. The shirt is you. People keep saying, is that such and such on the shirt? The shirt is, the face on the shirt is just abstract. The shirt is basically just a dude with an Afrikoid nose and big lips. So a lot of people are projecting whoever they want it to be or whoever they think it is. It's you. That shirt, this picture, represents all melanoid people. Some people say it look like Don Cheadle. Some people say it look like Raz. Some people say it look like Meek Mill. Some people say... It you project whoever onto it because that's you. That's you on the shirt, basically. And we're being sacrificed for the religion of white supremacy. So we got I'm not going to be on too long. I got a lot of stuff to do. I'm really doing a lot of stuff trying to get Hidden Colors 4 finished up. So I'm working very hard on that. My lecture in Toledo is going to be next week. I'll be in Toledo, Ohio next Saturday. So all my people around the Ohio area, around the Michigan area, I want to see your face in the place next week. I'll be in Toledo, Ohio. I'll be getting there Thursday night. I think I might be doing some radio out there Friday. Somebody said he thought it was Grace Jones. Now, you know good and well this wasn't no damn Grace Jones. Grace Jones ain't got... That ain't Grace Jones. But yeah, speak on that cop who killed himself. We ran a story on melanoidnation.org, which is the preeminent site of melanoid news worldwide. And don't forget, we're having Melanoid Empowerment Day, which is going to be December 1st. That's when you use the hashtag... Melanoid Empowerment Day. You're going to use that hashtag. You're going to take pictures holding up that fist and holding up money in that fist. Hold up a dollar in that fist to represent economic melanoid empowerment. That's what we're talking about, empowerment. But in Chicago, and I got a lot of stuff to talk about Chicago tonight. A lot of stuff to talk about pertaining to Chicago tonight. Shout out to Chicago, by the way. You know I got a lot of love for Chicago. Every time I go out there to Chicago, man, my lectures are sold out there. Chicago has always represented me way before Hidden Colors, even back in the day when I would just go out there and chop up game. People would come out, so Chicago was always represented. But there was a cop out there, a white cop, who was killed about a month ago. This is how cold white supremacy is. This is how cold white supremacy is. There was a cop who was killed. The word was, it was a couple of suspects. The suspects were some African-American males and a white male, and they were on the run. And these cops had all their resources looking for these African-American males and this one white suspect. So they're looking for these people, and they're blaming Black Lives Matter. You know that whole thing. All these Black Lives Matter people, which means all black people, by the way. You Black Lives Matter and black folks, you're fueling the flames of anti-cop rhetoric. So they were blaming black folks for this cop getting killed. Oh, where's Sharpton? Oh, where's Jesse? Oh, where's Obama? They were running their whole rhetoric bullshit. Now, come to find out, this cop actually shot himself. The cop killed himself, and the cop, from what I understand, if I'm not mistaken, the cop set it up to look like some black folks and some other suspects killed him. And I think he did it so that his family could get insurance money because he was in some kind of scandal. So he killed himself, and I think he was trying to set it up so that his family could get some insurance money. That's how cold these white supremacists are, man. They're getting so cold. They're willing to die for the cause and leave a little sum for the family. Oh, Claude Anderson's going to be in Chicago next Sunday. Y'all better go see Brother Claude. Y'all better go see Brother Claude and get that ism. Yeah, the dude ended up killing himself and tried to set it up to make it look like some other people killed him. These people are getting bold, man. And my condolences go out to the little melanoid boy, 9 years old. It was a little black boy who was killed. What was the young boy's name? He's 9 years old. He got killed. What's his name? Ty something. What's his name? Where are my Chicago people? What's his name? I was talking about him earlier. What's up, Bite Size Maya? Shout out to Birmingham. What you doing out there in Birmingham, Bite Size Maya? But the kid in Chicago, Tyshawn Lee, there you go. There's a little boy who was killed in Chicago. His name is Tyshawn Lee, 9 years old. Now, the reports coming out, because he was shot. All we know is that he was shot. But there is no suspect. Follow me. Little melanoid boy was shot. He's 9 years old. There's no suspect. They're going around offering all types of reward money to find the suspect for this little boy who was shot in Chicago. Now, I just said there's no suspect, but the cops and everybody in the media, they're going around talking about it was gang related. They're talking about he was lured into an alley and possibly killed over his father's gang affiliation. If there's no suspect, how in the fuck do you know that? If there is no suspect, how you know all this stuff? So this is why this whole thing is looking real funny style to me, man. That looks real funny style to me. They're talking about, they got this whole gang affiliation story, but there's no suspect. So when I'm asking people this and nobody can give a straight answer, how are you going to have all of this? It was a gang thing and it was a gang affiliation, but you ain't got no suspect. How you know? How you know he was lured in an alley and killed? When the cops throw shit like that out there, I'm looking at them funny style because there was a story on Melanoid Nation go to Melano Nation or Google this story. We talked about how the corruption with the police out there in Chicago, where many people believe that they're behind some of these people getting killed in the streets. There's even video of a person who appears to be a white undercover cop doing a drive-by shooting. That's on melanoidnation.org too. But I'm not, to be honest, I'm not buying the whole gang story. I'm not buying that, family. I'm not buying that. You got this so-called gang member that done shot him and now they can't find him. Bullshit, dude. I'm calling all types of bullshit on that. Because if that was the real case and it was really gang affiliated and okay, what gang is it? I mean, they're just throwing out these baseless theories because they know that people will buy that. Anything you say that a gang did, people will buy it. 20 people got shit killed. It was a gang. The Crips and Bloods are going to get together in Baltimore. Ooh, we need to send rockets and tanks out there. You understand what I'm saying? I'm going to get on that mom, his mom and dad in a minute. I'll get on the mom and dad in a minute. Because the mom is a certified hood rat from what I've been seeing, by the way. But it's just real funny style, man. I'm just right now, I'm just not buying the whole he got lured into an alley and shot by a gang member for some gang affiliation. Because number one, they have zero proof of that. And if that's the case, why don't they have a suspect? So when the cops start making up motives, that lets me know that they might be onto something. I wouldn't be surprised if a cop killed that kid. I wouldn't be surprised if it's organ stealing out there. I wouldn't be surprised. They're trying to say that the mother and father are gang affiliated, but dude, everybody's gang affiliated if you're black, dude. Do you understand that? I want you to, Kiki, Natural, I really want you to understand this. Gang affiliated is a bullshit term. Every black person is gang affiliated. You will say, well, I ain't part of no gang. Nigga, if you wear a blue, a purple, a green shirt, the white supremacists can say that's a gang color. All of us are gang affiliated, dude. Well, we saw some black suspects. They had on gang affiliated colors. They say that in the media all the time. If you live on a block that has known gang activity, that makes you gang affiliated with the white supremacists. Do you understand me, man? If you live on a street that has ever had a mugging or a robbery by a gang member, that makes you, according to the white supremacists, gang affiliated. That's a net term that will encompass all of us. If you got a cousin who knows a gang member, you're gang affiliated. All of us are potentially gang affiliated. If you ever you take a picture with your hand a certain way, that's a gang sign. That's gang affiliated. Y'all remember that time, and I think it was in Minnesota, they were trying to shame this white female politician. She was hanging out with some people. They were doing some grassroots campaigning, and she was taking a picture with a black dude, and he threw up the peace sign, and she threw up the peace sign. They were like, oh, she's throwing up gang signs. In the system of white supremacy, everything you do is gang affiliated. So get off that. Oh, somebody was gang affiliated. All of us are. They can use that. That's the go-to bullshit. It was the mayor. That's right. So again, with the situation in Chicago, I just wouldn't put it past the cops. Look, I live in L.A. I'm from L.A., man. I live in L.A. in the 90s. Dude, we had a gang truce out here. The cops broke that shit up. There were police officers behind a lot of gang activity out here, man. And they were blaming it on rival gangs. The police were behind a lot of gang activity, but they were blaming it on rival gangs. So we know what they're capable of doing. We know what they're capable of doing. But I just don't see some dude from some little gang, street gang, because that's what you're talking about. Street gangs are powerless. Street gangs are powerless. I'm just not feeling or believing that story. Number one, if you are in a gang and you did a murder that bold and brazen and that heartless, the whole block would be hot, or whatever gang they suspected it to be. Number two, with all of the informants that's out there right now, somebody would have gave dude up. If somebody did that, somebody would have gave, and they given up $54,000, and the reward money is up to $50,000+ at this point. You think somebody ain't gonna tell on a nigga who did for 50 grand out there in Chicago? In some of those neighborhoods that's segregated and people are starving out there, you think they ain't gonna give somebody up for 50 G's and then bounce? Out there in Chicago, everybody's ears to the streets trying to find out who it is. They can't wait to find out who it is so they can snitch on them. That's why I don't believe it was some gang member. I just don't believe it was some random gang member. They would have gave him up already. They would have snitched his ass out. There's niggas in jail now who know more shit, who got their ear to the streets more than people on the streets. Dudes in jail be having the ear to the streets. They know what the fuck is going on. They look for information so they can use to get out. You got dudes clamoring trying to find out who did it. That's why I don't believe it. I don't believe it was some random gang member. I just don't believe it. So cops might be behind that shit. And that's another thing. You don't target kids. That's one rule, man. You don't target kids. Real gang members. Kiki, I don't know what she said. I'm not reading it. But real gang members, you don't target kids. That's bullshit. Real gang members, you don't target no kids. Kids have always been off limits. No gang is going to have members who's out here shooting kids because you know it's going to make your whole hood hot. Let's just talk on some street shit, dude. Let's just keep it on some street shit. No gang is going to green light a motherfucker hitting a kid. You know the block is going to be hot. You're going to shut down everybody's money. Because with the gangs, somebody's going to have to be out here making some money. You just ain't going to be out here gang banging for nothing. Dudes gang bang in order to protect what little trap money they're making. Or you gang bang in order to protect the track, or protect something out there in the hood that makes money. That's what it's really about. You're trying to protect something to make some paper. That's where the gang banging comes in. So if you're in a gang, let's just talk real shit. Forget about, y'all listen to what the white supremacists tell you. They tell you the sky is falling. According to them, just zombie niggas out here running around high on flocka, just doing random shit, killing women, kids, children. And y'all sit up, man, we need to stop it. Take time and think about what's going on out here. But when you out here, if you shoot somebody, if you're a gangbanger who's out here trying to make some money, you shoot a motherfucker, somebody affiliated with you, or your gang is out here popping kids, that shuts down the block. Your money is fucked up. Ain't nobody making paper. They're going around knocking on doors, flipping niggas, locking cats up, shaking them down for information. Nobody's that stupid. You would have to be a stupid motherfucker to shoot a kid right now. And you're supposed to be in a gang. You would have to be a stupid motherfucker. And a stupid motherfucker cannot evade the cops for what? How many days has it been? How many days has it been? Let's just be real. How many days has it been since that kid been shot? Let's just think with fucking common sense. Because if you're smart enough to get away from from law enforcement these many days, you would be smart enough not to do a move like that. And to shoot a kid like that, that's a crackhead move. And a crackhead nigga like that would be caught overnight. They would be caught that night. That's some crackhead nigga shit if it was on some street gang shit. Now, if it was a cop or somebody who did it on a professional level, then you can evade it. You can evade capture. Think about that. Just think about that. Because they get dumb niggas every day. You can get a dumb nigga for doing a crime. You get them in 48 hours. That's why they have the show First 48. It's been about a week and a half. So it's been about a week and a half. And it's been a week and a half. Somebody killed a kid in Chicago. And they can't find him. And they got surveillance cameras all over the place. So this killer knew how to evade surveillance cameras the whole nine yards for a whole week and can't nobody find him. I call bullshit. I call bullshit. That sounds like some cop shit right there, homies. That sounds like some cop shit. Chicago is way too segregated for a motherfucker to be dipping and dodging and hiding. Now, Chicago is the most segregated city in the country. No other city is more segregated than Chicago. Chicago, look it up. It's the most racially segregated city in the country. Major city. So where is this killer gonna go? He's only limited to certain areas. Somebody would have snitched on him. That's why I know this shit is funny style. This shit is funny style. Something ain't right with this. I'm not believing the whole gang story. But I know the cops now. The cops are crooked as hell. The cops out there have a history of doing foul shit. The cops had like a little torture Guantanamo Bay area out there where they were torturing people for years. They had to pay out reparations to the families of people being tortured out there in Chicago by the cops. I know the cops are scandalous as shit. So I wouldn't, that's why I'm looking, I keep my eye on the white supremacists. If they're trying to tell me something and it don't make sense, I'm looking at you like this. I'm looking at your ass. And let's get on that mom. And the mom and dad are too. This kid's mom and dad are idiots. The mom is a certified hood rat. She got a bunch of stripping videos where she's stripping. She put up a GoFundMe page. And from what I understand, some of the money for the funeral, because she was trying to raise money for the funeral, she went out and bought a damn car with the money. Then she made a video talking about, well, I need a car for protection because they might get me too. She sound like a certified rat. The dad of the kid, they're talking about this gang-affiliated dad. He's selling T-shirts with his son's picture painted on it. I'm like, okay, okay. All right. The city, yeah, I heard that too. I heard the city is paying for the funeral, but they done raised some money and they're pocketing the money. So the poor child's parents are on some bullshit. The dad, I looked at his Instagram. This nigga got bundles of money. This was before the death of the boy. The dad all flosses. You know, he's one of these niggas that's floss. Every other picture, he's flossing money, but now you need a damn GoFundMe page to bury your son. Nigga, stop with the whole flossing on the internet shit, too. Stop with that flossing on the internet shit, too. This nigga, the dad, y'all niggas, that's the dustiest shit ever. Y'all on Instagram, niggas, stop all that flossing with money shit. Please cut that dumb shit out. Y'all flossing with money, you got stacks of money, bed full of money, money on the kitchen table. Every other picture, you got money, but you need a damn GoFundMe page to bury your son. You clown-ass niggas. And the mom, again, I don't know. Something's fishy about them, too. The mom out here buying cars, and she's worrying about what people are saying about her on Instagram. her dumb ass talking about, my son in a better place. Don't worry about me. My son in a better place now. What the fuck are you talking about, niggas? Are y'all niggas that fucking mentally enslaved? You will sacrifice your fucking kids in order to floss and just do flossy nigga shit. Using your kids as a come up. You'll let your kids die. That'll give you some turn up money. You dusty bum niggas. That's why none of these cases can never go to the Supreme Court. They cash these dusty niggas out with peanut money. And then make a deal where you can't prosecute. Oh yeah, Crispy. Yeah, Crispy used that money for child support again. And all you dumb niggas that keep giving them money too. Because anybody listening to Crispy, you know this. It's like with the dude who called my show one of Crispy's listeners. You see how stupid they are. If you're that stupid knowing that a nigga is a scam artist and you still giving them paper, and a motherfucker done scam you and ain't gave shit and just running more game and you still give them more paper, you deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve for him to fuck you silly out of your paper. You deserve it. You deserve it. Especially to let an ashy, crispy, bummy nigga fuck you out of money. You deserve it. You deserve to let a nigga scam you out of money so he can pay off his child support of all his damn kids that he ain't taking care of. You deserve it. You deserve that nigga to scam your dumb ass if you sit up listening to that type of thing. That's right. Idiots deserve to be ripped off. I feel sorry for nobody. If you get screwed multiple times by the same nigga who didn't produce nothing, you deserve it. I ain't even mad at him. I'm not mad at him. Miss Braxton, everything the dude does is a fraud. That's why people, y'all don't have to hit me up telling me what big of a fraud Crispy is. I know. Hey man, Tariq Crispy had lied about once. I don't care. I know. Yeah, game. Yeah. Me, Zoe, Coriola, we cool in the game. Yeah, but he's a coon. He's a lying coon, of course. You don't have to tell me. He's a lying coon. He does what lying coons do. Well, the latest episode is Paranegro Activity, so you guys can see that. And I got some more Crispy stuff coming up. I got a whole Crispy website, the Crispy Puppet website, going. And I got some more stuff coming with the Crispy Puppet brand. People love that Crispy Puppet brand. People have been talking to me about getting it on TV because the Crispy episodes are funny as hell. What's up? You got people questioning the legitimacy of Hidden Colors? Dude, either it's right or wrong. It's that simple. I don't listen to that. Those somebody questioning the legitimacy. That's just a motherfucker trolling. Because the movie, man, Hidden Colors has been out. The series has been going for, what, five years almost? And you ain't been able to prove anything wrong yet. So they're just trolling. Either you can prove something wrong or you're trolling. And if there was some shit that was inaccurate in there, it would have been called out a long time ago. All right? If there was something inaccurate, it would have been called out. I don't even listen to no shit like that. Those are people who are trolling. That's why with Hidden Colors, when people get so desperate because you can't debunk the information, I can give you every... You pick out something in Hidden Colors, I find a reference, or at least three reference books to it. That's why it takes a long time to get it cracking, because we make sure we dot the I's and cross the T's. Yeah, either prove something is wrong or get the fuck on somewhere. And the most they can do is start talking about what ain't in there. Well, you didn't mention the Hebrew Israelites. Okay, niggas. All right, now if you're going to start whining about what's not in there, okay, go sit the fuck down somewhere. Well, you didn't mention Noble Drew Ali. All right, sit down, nigga. All right. Just sit down. That's just desperate. You're desperate to find something to try to debunk. When you debunk shit that ain't even in there, all right. All right. That's just coons looking for attention. I can't wait till Hidden Colors 4 come out, man. We dropping that fire. We going all the way there with that hot fire. And that's going to be released probably around February 2016. That's what we're looking for. We're looking at February 2016. Is Ola in the room? Is Ola in here yet? What's up, Tenali? Crispy ain't making that nigga Crispy ain't making no movie. Y'all don't know. A fraud is a fraud is a fraud. Y'all just don't understand how much a fraud some people can be. Oh, you want to buy this shirt? You can get this shirt and many others like it at TariqElite.com. Somebody type that in the room, please. TariqElite.com. And please stop asking for random people who's going to be in Hidden Colors, because some of these people I don't even know. Is Dr. Tommy Curry? I don't know who that is, to be honest. So that's another thing. Y'all got to stop doing that. Y'all be asking me about random people. You know, that's kind of pointless, asking me about random people if they're going to be in Hidden Colors or not. Just people that pop up in your brain. Is Lola Falana going to be in Hidden Colors? I don't know. Why? What's up, baby? What the boys doing? They're playing okay. Is Dr. Pepper going to be in Hidden Colors 4? I know. Yeah, because now I got people trying to, like, basically audition to be in Hidden Colors. So now it's like, I'm cool. What's up, baby? What you got? Let me see your shirt. Let everybody see your shirt. Sweetie. Come around here, girl. What's that?
You need this.
No, I'm going to throw that away. Say the Malcolm X hologram. Hilarious. They see Billy Blank's going to... It's Tupac. Yeah, they be asking me about some of the randomest fucking people. I'm like, who are you talking about? Nigga, is Betty Shabazz's great cousin's auntie going to be in there? Oh, somebody's crying up there, man. Say, would I put Obama? Oh, yes, I would, because I would ask President Obama some hellified questions, bruh. I would ask some real questions. But didn't they catch Ben Carson lying about something? Ben Carson was lying about some of his credentials. What was this nigga lying about? He was lying about something. Joy DeGruy, she was already, and she was in Hidden Colors 3. She was in Hidden Colors 3. So I need a Crispy Hidden Colors parody. Larry. Did y'all see that picture of Crispy as a child? His brother sent. That's the funniest fucking picture. Did y'all see that? Where is that picture? Hold on. That's my sister. Hold on. Let me see. I peanut in your camera. I saw your head like a second. This is my sister. What's up, Tia? Everybody say what's up to my sister, Tia. Everybody say, what's up, Tia, to my sister. Everybody say, what's up, Tia. Let me find that. I got to find that crispy picture. I made that shit my profile one day. I think I laughed for about 3 hours when I first saw it. What are my boys doing?
TJ said wants some.
Oh, you give him some? What are you doing, T? Let me see if Sia. I gotta find that picture, fam. What's up? It's my. Oh! This is a Seer. A Seer's getting big. A Seer is. He'll be 9 months next week, right?
Yes. Yeah. Hi, Tia. Tia says she sees. She saw me.
Yeah. Look at that Seer. Hold on. I'm gonna give him a mustache. Now he look like, don't even my son look like El Chapo?
No.
Peanut hates for me to say that, but next Halloween, I'm going to have him go as El Chapo. Still has a little diaper rash. He's been screaming. His little booty. Poor fella. Why is my child's head so big? His head matches your mama's stomach, nigga. His head is big because he went trick-or-treating as your mama's fucking gut. Now, and this is the pubic hair of your mom's. That's the stomach, you bitch ass nigga.
Hi, everybody. Come say hi.
That's why. Now, who said that? So I can. Mr. Marvin, your ass. Hold on. Well, I got my eye on you, Mr. Marvin. That's my big boy, TJ. I got my eye on you, Mr. Marvin, you bitch ass nigga.
Yay! He's your face.
Hey, say hi.
Say hi. Say hi.
Let me put on some music, because my sons, when they hear music, they turn. Hi! When they hear music, they turn up. What you writing to you? TJ wrote all on the walls. I was sleeping. I said, let me let him go downstairs and kick it by himself. TJ got a pencil and wrote all over the damn house. He wrote all on the computer. Let me put on some music for them and let them turn up.
He's laughing. He likes the camera.
He likes it? Let me see if they'll turn up. Oh, I hate these two commercials.
Hold on, buddy.
I'm getting restless.
So let me do it, and I'll do it.
Hold on.
It'll be an honor and a privilege to do it.
Andre. Y'all disturbing me. Hold on.
There's no match.
All right, here we go. All right, here we go. We're gonna see it. Tuxedo. I know that's the jam. That's the jam. So I see it look like Drake. Okay, I see it looking like, what the fuck is going on?
TJ likes it.
TJ's turned up and see it like, what the hell is going on? My sister. Okay, y'all tearing up down here, man. Come on. Somebody said, hi, yellow family. Hilarious. I ain't high yellow. The kids are, but I ain't. All right. I think his shit needs to be changed. Well, I don't want his diaper rash to be. He said, you give me $500, let you claim TJ. What for this boy? No. Income tax. Did TJ eat a booger? Did he eat a booger? See, you got that kitty curl. But yeah, man, that whole thing about Chicago. Hold on.
Let's see if he likes this.
What is anyone? Oh, that's too strong. That's like too strong. Yeah, that's too strong. And again, man, I'm gonna be in Toledo, Ohio next week. So you guys don't wanna miss that. Oh, what you did? She did dancing. Get it, buddy. Best way to contact me. The best way to contact me is info@tariqalee.com. Now see, he's looking, he's distracted, so when he turns around, he gets it in. What are you doing over there, T? Should be getting his groove on in the morning. Have I been down to the MLK Museum in Atlanta? I have not. I have not been inside of it. Yeah, I have not been inside of it. Get it, T. Okay, I gotta talk now. I can't have the music playing all the way through. Sarah looks like Tariq and TJ looks more like Peanut. Some people say it's the other way. Some people say it's the other way. Man, but yeah, but what's going on in Chicago? We're talking about Chicago early. It's some real funny style stuff going on, especially with those parents of that kid. I see it look like he got grown-up problems.
TJ.
Yeah, Sia had a bad little diaper rash. Shout out to that sister who sent me those cakes. That Let Them Eat Cake Company. She sent me some more. I've been tearing them shits up.
Oh, and that lady who sent the hair products. Oh, yeah,
the lady who sent me the hair products. See, I wish Peanut bring it down so I can show people. It's
called like Kira. I don't know. It's good, though.
It's real good. I want to let people know what it is. This sister sent me some stuff, and I use it on TJ's hair. It smells good. It's real good for his hair. And the sister makes it. What's up, Asir? Because when one of them gets turned up, the other one gets turned up. What is it? Okay. Well, get these babies. Man. What's the name? I'm going to find out the name. And shout out to the sister. She sent me a whole bunch of stuff. She got like some soaps, and I've been bathing with that shit. My skin is all smooth. It's some stuff she has that I've been putting in TJ's hair. It smells real good. It smells like chocolate. Yeah, it smells like chocolate. It's real, like cocoa chocolate. It's real good stuff. That's not my sister. Yeah, Sid's gonna be a big boy. Yeah, the Chi-Raq movie. I want to see what it's about.
What are you getting?
Yeah, I want to see what that Chi-Raq movie is about. What?
Daddy.
That's his way of saying daddy. Like, I die. Thank you. What? Crispy could use hilarious. I got a, what is that sister's? See, I get so many people sending stuff.
Which one? Can you get it?
Yeah, can you get it?
Which one?
Get the chocolate stuff.
The hair stuff?
The hair stuff. Yeah, just get the hair stuff. Then I can give y'all the name of her products.
The cake is bomb. Hey.
Yeah, Peanut's going to get the stuff right now. Yeah, you say Nick Cannon is playing the lead. Yeah, the casting seems kind of weird. I saw some of the trailer for the Chi-Raq movie. And I gotta check it out. You know? You know, I was one of the associate producers on Spike Lee's last movie. The movie about the vampires. Let's see it. Come on, buddy. Y'all look at the credits on that. Okay, buddy. Okay, see? Oh, your mama's gonna get you, buddy. I do have to come back to D.C. I do have to come back to D.C. All right. So these are the... Okay, so these are the product. This is called Kriya Kids.
Well, this is the name of it. Kriya Botanical, but that's
a good okay, place. Hold on. So, I'm going to give y'all some more names. This is good. We use this on TJ's here. This is for kids. She has something else called Kriya Botanicals. Is this for the hair, too?
Yeah, all of it's for the hair.
Uh-huh. Okay.
She's seen a lot of stuff. That's just a couple of them.
She said that. It's the sister who makes this stuff. Real good stuff. Smells extremely good. Let me, where's her website? Hold on. Let me see if she has a website. Hold on. KriyaBotanicals.com. It's K-R-I-Y-A Botanicals.com. That's where you can go to her site. This is like a leave-in conditioner. I mean, this stuff smells really good.
All of them are basically the same thing.
Okay, this is another one she has called Fruit Smoothie. And the kids will love it. Okay, my kids are getting restless. Take them up there and let them watch Mickey Mouse.
He's getting excited.
So that's kids, the Fruit Smoothie, Kriya Botanicals. And the kids love it. You put it in their hair. It smells good. It holds good.
In my hair too.
Yeah, Peanut puts it in her hair. I might put it in my joints and see what it do. I ain't got no hair, but I'll make it do what it do anyway. Yeah, but this is some good stuff, man. So a sister makes this, and again, it's KriyaBotanicals.com. So holler at that sister, KriyaBotanicals.com. You say Mickey Mouse is a racist cartoon? Dude. If we're going there, there's a whole bunch of them. You got to go down the list. Say, let them watch Hidden Colors. TJ, what are you doing over there?
He likes to watch Crispy.
I know, they love watching the Crispy car. They be laughing their asses off at the Crispy puppet.
What's funny?
Now, Sear, he's, when I do the puppet live, Sear is scared of it. TJ loves the Crispy puppet. But Sear, like, when the puppet's like, whatever, everybody. Huh? I don't know what I'm seeking in Houston. I got an invitation to go to Dallas. There's some kind of award show. Martin Luther King celebration. They just invited me to that. That's happening in January. I don't know if I'm going yet because I don't know what they want me to do. I don't know if they want me to get up and say something. Because sometimes, what is that? What's that? Will you tell your kids about the Lord yet? But, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'll be up there in a minute because I got to watch some of those shows. You feel me?
Walking Dead.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I got to watch The Walking Dead.
You ready to go upstairs?
You got to give them a bath in a minute, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, they woke up just a little bit ago, so they're not that tired.
Right.
You ready to go?
Yeah, but I do have to go back out to D.C.
Come on, T.
Have I thought about doing a Hidden Colors animation? I don't know. I don't know yet. Yeah, that I don't know yet.
Come on.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye, T. Yeah, Jim Brown is spitting. I'm telling you, James Small is spitting that hot fire. Let me tell y'all who's really, really spitting that because everybody's spitting hot fire, but in Hidden Colors 4, because there's a lot of people who stand out to me, because everybody has their favorite person. So there's a lot of standout people, like in Hidden Colors 2, even though he wasn't, he was in certain parts. I think Claude Anderson was a big standout. You dig? But they were just different standout people. You know, people got the ones they like the most in the series. Sometimes Shahrazad Ali, people say she's the standout. So Umar's the standout person. There's so many standout people. In Hidden Colors 4, I think James Small, the fire he's spitting is extra hot. He's a standout. Oh, James Small is brilliant. I love that brother. He's so deep. He's so deep, and he's breaking it down, man. He's really standing out in this one. Umar's not in this one. Umar's not in Hidden Colors 4. Yeah, a lot of folks like, yeah. But Umar's, he's not in 4. And also, James Small stands out in Hidden Colors 4, and Killer Mike. Nigga, Killer Mike is going raw. Killer Mike is spitting, man. Killer Mike is spitting in Hidden Colors 4, man. So they stand out a lot. Yeah, a lot of people, that's another favorite. Dr. Cabba. You know, everybody just, they love everybody. And that's why I make the movies like an all-star situation. Oh, no, 90 Day Fiancé, I haven't seen it. I haven't seen the new one. No, but that show is funny. That one dude, man, he did not want to bang that ugly-ass lady. That one Muslim dude. That nigga came up with every excuse in the book not to bang that lady. Fiverr, okay, Flavor, whatever your name is, you asking some real janky questions, brother. Yeah, David Banner, he's phenomenal. Dick Gregory. Oh, Lord. Dick Gregory be getting on folks. And shout out to brother Dick Gregory. Y'all know there's another video of Dick Gregory going off on somebody again. There's another video of Dick Gregory going off again. Let me play that now. Because y'all remember a few months ago, I played a video of Dick Gregory going off on somebody during an interview. It don't take much for Dick Gregory to go off. It does not take much for Dick Gregory to go off. If you ask Dick Gregory the wrong question or you ask it in the wrong way, bam, he goes there on your ass. Dick Gregory goes all the way left on you. It's so funny. I'm going to find the crispy pick. I'm going to look for the crispy pick. I'm going to find it and I'm going to post it. Hold on. But let me play this Dick Gregory clip first. Let me play the Dick Gregory clip first because this shit is hilarious. Hold on. Let me play that Dick Gregory clip. All right. This brother, they're doing an interview about Michael Jackson. And the brother, he asked kind of a simple question. He's like, well, I thought it had something to do with Sony. And then... he shouldn't have asked that. He shouldn't have said nothing. You haven't done nothing until you've been cussed out by Dick Gregory. You dig? Dick Gregory will snap on you. So check this out.
The white boy said we got to get rid of you, but we'll ease you out. So then he comes and he works in Virginia, which is called the CIA, and now he's the police chief of New York. I'm a fucking criminal. Gangster. That's what it's about.
Well, I thought it was because of the Sony thing. They wanted he. I believe there was some.
But that's because you don't have the information.
Okay.
Huh?
Okay.
I said he was killed by a laser. Mm-hmm. Huh? I just told you it was a bloody shirt and the money. Just public. All you gotta do is go look it up. Huh? Okay. I didn't come here to find out what you think.
No, I'm just asking.
No, you didn't. You said you thought. I'm not interviewing you. You interviewing me? I don't want to hear it.
Okay.
Huh? But you go do it. I respect who you're going to be. So don't sit here and tell me you thought it was the Sony thing. Huh? Okay. What was the Sony thing about? Tell my grandmother.
Well, my understanding was that he was going to get the Beatles catalog.
And he already had it. Huh?
Okay.
He bought the Beatles catalog when his people told him don't buy it. He bought it for $48 million. When they killed him, it was worth $2.5 billion. Huh? Mm-hmm. Huh? Stuff going on in your house I don't know nothing about. There's a persona out there I don't know nothing about. But when we're sitting here with respect for one, I don't want to hear what you thought. Mm-hmm. I saw the check, nigga. Huh? Mm-hmm. So I got to sit here and what you thought. Who cares? Mm-hmm. Huh? That's all.
I saw the check, nigga. Man, y'all better leave Dick Gregory alone and just let him talk, man. Man, y'all let Dick Gregory talk, dude. Man. Man. You gotta love Dick Gregory. Dick Gregory is funny, man. Dick Gregory is funny. Man. Dick Gregory be snapping. It was an episode of Zoe Williams' show. Dick Gregory was snapping on Zoe Williams and Bobby and those dudes, too. Zoe Williams, he was snapping. I mean, Dick Gregory was snapping on Zoe and those dudes. Like, damn. Oh, my God. Look, the show Empire. Y'all been watching Empire. You know, speaking of Empire. Oh, let me. By the way, the brand new shirts right here. Called Crucifixion. Bam. Available right now at TariqElite.com. TariqElite.com. Get yours right now. We got them in black. We got them in brown. Get yours right now. Get yours right now. But yeah, on Empire. Empire, man. Some of the writing. They're slacking on the writing, man. They're really slacking on the writing with Empire. I love Power, by the way. Somebody's mentioning, but Power is on a whole different level. But Empire, man, the writing, they gotta tighten up the writing, dude. There's too much agenda shit going on in it now. And I don't know who's writing it, but the writing is kind of all over the place. I'm trying to follow it. I'm trying to rock with it. I'm rooting for the series. But yeah, we got to let go of the agenda stuff. They keep crowbarring gay stuff, man. Okay, we get it. You don't have to crowbar that in. What's the dude, the Smollett guy? What's his character's name? Not Hakeem, not... What the fuck? Andre Jamal. Jamal is the gay one, right? The Jamal character is the gay one, right? That's his name. So the gay brother. Yeah, they keep crowbarring the gay stuff in there. All right, we get it, but you okay, y'all. It don't have shit to do with nothing. They keep crowbarring that in there. And the Jamal character. Writers, I want y'all to listen. I get on that whole scene with Gabby Sidibe doing a fucking sex scene. Was the most grotesque shit on television. I get on that in a minute, man. But Jamal, the character Jamal, You don't have to have this nigga singing every 2 minutes. Okay. They got him singing every 5 minutes in the show. It's us. Alright. Y'all don't have to have him singing in the every 5 minutes. I don't know if they're using that as a filler. I don't know if they're trying to just promote the gay character more to give him shine, to make him the star. But it's annoying him singing every 5 fucking minutes. The shit has turned into Glee. Jamal, every time something happens, this nigga singing with these fucking moist damn V-neck sweaters and shirts he's wearing all the time. All right, dude, I don't want to hear this nigga singing every 5 fucking minutes, man. Give me some acting. Every 5 minutes, there's a good scene going, and it's ruined with his ass. You see somebody about to get killed, and all of a sudden, they cut to a studio with this nigga. My dad love me. Dad love me. I just want to run away. I'm like, nigga, I don't want to see you sing. All right. See, they can pull back. I know it's supposed to be a music show, but they can pull back on some of this shit. Then they got Terrence Howard rapping. Hard out here for my family, man. I wrote a story. Y'all like, okay, all right, man. All right. Y'all killing me with this shit. The moist nigga singing, then Terrence Howard rapping. He's supposed to be this big rapper back in the day, but this nigga's rhymes. Oh, come on, y'all taking me out of the movie, out of the show, man. Okay, with these Lucius Lyon rhymes. These rhymes, I'm supposed to believe that he was a big-time dude who built an empire off his rhymes. Like, I wrote a song for you, Hakeem. Here it is, I'm going to rap it for you, Hakeem. Growing up in the streets, I was the main. I was doing it like this, selling cocaine. I'm like, oh, okay, all right. All right, man. All right. Then Jamal coming in. I gotta get out of the streets. I'm like, just act. Y'all, don't turn this into a fucking High School Musical, man. Yeah, now that Frida Gatz chick, she can rap. I mean, all right, they're good. They're good. Yeah, when you got the guest stars in there rapping and doing their thing, that's good. That's good. But yeah, but come on. With those Lucius Lyon bars are not the business. I'm just going to go say it, man. Them Lucius Lyon bars are not the business. And y'all know they're not the business, man. I'm like, okay, you built an empire off that? Me and Cookie was out here hustling in the streets. We had no money. We had nothing to eat. Okay. All right, Lucius. But then this week, man, they had a scene where this dude was banging Gabby Sidibe. And that's the thing. When they have black love scene, everything with us has to be bestial. It has to look animalistic. It has to be some crazy looking shit. This woman, morbidly obese. And they've always ridiculed Gabby, and I don't like them doing that. And I'm not shitting on Gabby. I'm not shitting on her. That's our sister. I'm not shitting on her. That sister can't, you know, she's a morbidly obese sister. And I'm not shitting on her. But I'm shitting on the people that will put her in love scenes. And, you know, they used to put her on the cover of fashion magazines as a way to ridicule her. And even that, I don't like what they did. They had her in a sex scene to ridicule her. She's throwing that big ass leg up on this dude's back. I was eating some chips and I gave my chips away to my dog. I lost my appetite. That shit was not fly. There's nothing fly about that. So what's the purpose of you showing some shit like that? What's the purpose of you showing something like that? And I say it looks bestial because it makes our shit has to look bestial. There's no romance. Whenever they show black love or black intimacy, it has to be on some degrade shit. It's not romantic. It's not fly. There's no sensitivity to it. You know, that you get a morbidly obese black person. You're turning into something crazy looking. She has a big blonde weave on, looking like she's about to fall over from diabetes, throwing her big ass leg up on a nigga's back. It has to be some old crazy looking shit. You never see no shit like that with white women on TV. You never see no shit like that. It looks crazy. That ain't sexy. That's not paying homage to big women and all that shit. It ain't. That makes us look crazy. And let's just be real. This is supposed, the dude who she was banging, he's supposed to be, wait a minute. All right, I lost the stream for 1 minute, family, but I'm here. I'm back. Hold on. I'm waiting on it to come back. Let me do this. I gotta refresh the page. All right, hold on 1 second. Hold on one goddamn second, everybody. Hold on 1 second. That ginger beer is making me burp. All right, family. Let me let everybody know to refresh the page. Refresh your pages. All right, I'm back, family. Sorry about that. I got cut off. I don't know what happened. But I'm still here. And I'm still making it do what it do. We're getting in the room. We're flowing in here. I got to go shortly. But before I go, we're going to still chop up some game about stuff. Say she look like a Snorlax. Hilarious. Yes, we are back. Hey, don't forget. Go to TariqElite.com. Get these shirts. And also, to join me next week in Toledo, go to TariqLive.com. TariqLive.com. Who's in Toledo? If you're in Toledo, let me know. Because I got to get a cameraman while I'm out there to film my lecture. Who does camera work in Toledo? If you're in Toledo, let me know. I need to get a camera person out there to film my stuff. Where are my Toledo people? If you're in Toledo, email me at info@TariqElite.com. info@TariqElite.com. The crispy pick. All right, where's the crispy pick? Let me find that for you. Hold on. Let me show y'all the Crispy pic of Crispy when he was a kid. His brother sent me this picture. It's a picture of Crispy's family and Crispy when he was a kid. This is a real picture. This is not Photoshop, by the way. Hold on. Can't hear my son's crying. Hold on. Okay. All right. This is the real Crispy and his family. This nigga. Y'all see which one Crispy was, right? He wasn't the tall. That's the oldest brother. The youngest one was on the other side. You can tell which one is Crispy. This nigga. His hairline has always been fucked up. This nigga had a fucked up hairline as a child. Let me show it again. This nigga had a fucked up ass hairline as a baby. And the dude in the picture, by the way, understand, let me give y'all some history about Crispy, which I don't like to go too much into it, but this is what his brother told me. The man in the picture, that's not Crispy's real dad. The man with the mustache, that's not Crispy's real dad. See, the older kid, the tall kid, and Crispy, they got two different fathers. The lady is, they're all their mothers. And the other young boy, that's his father and Crispy's mother. So Crispy's mother and the guy in the picture, their only biological child together is the youngest one, which is Crispy's brother. That's the one I chopped it up with. So the man in the picture, that's not Crispy's real father. Now, his brother told me that Crispy's father was married and had an affair with his mother, with Crispy's mother, and had Crispy. This is real talk. This is real shit. So Crispy was born out of an affair. Crispy was born out of an affair. This is why this nigga's so mad at women and his mother. His brother told me, and this is real, I'm not making none of this up. This ain't no joke. His brother told me that Crispy curses his mother out. That's why I have zero respect for Crispy's ass. His brother told me that Crispy has cussed his mother out several times. Cussed their mother out. That's why this nigga don't like women. Black women in particular. That's why that nigga, if somebody hates black women that much, there's a history behind that shit. That's where that shit stems from. That's why that nigga cannot stand his mother and other people who look like his mother, because that nigga was born out of an affair, and that nigga was deprived of a dad, and that nigga looked at his mom as somebody who did something immoral. That nigga, it's some deep shit with him. That's where that comes from. That's where that shit comes from. That nigga can't stand his mom. Because he looks at his, all the slut whores and bitches and black bitches that he talks about who sleep with all these married men. And he's talking about his mom. That's how he feels about his mother, because his mama was messing with a married man and had his Crispy ass. And he didn't have his dad, and his dad didn't really want anything to do with him because he was in a relationship. So now he's doing the same shit. He's, Crispy has a bunch of kids he ain't taking care of like his dad. Real, real heavy shit, man. It's some real sick shit. That's why his brother almost whooped his ass at his mom's house, because he was, Crispy be going over there cussing his mama out. Nigga hates his mother. That's why I'm like, his mom, I'm looking at his mom's Facebook page. She don't have one reference to this nigga. So that shit gotta hurt when your relationship with your own mama is so fucked up that she don't even really acknowledge you. Yeah, so in his mind, his mom is like this ghetto ratchet thing. So this nigga talking about follows America. He's talking about himself. It's some real deep shit. But yeah, Crispy is cussed him. And this is his brother telling me. This ain't no, I heard it through the streets. His own brother told me this. I had his brother on my show. His own brother told me this. I'm not, that shouldn't be an excuse. I mean, there's no excuse to cuss your mama out. Anybody who follows a nigga who cusses out his own mama, you ain't shit. For following a nigga who curses out his own mom, nah, you ain't shit for following a nigga like that. But yeah, that nigga was born out of an affair. So that nigga was born with a negative image of black women. That nigga was born into that shit with a negative image of black women and infidelity and lies and deceit. He was born into that shit. That shit is in that nigga's DNA. That's why it's so easy for this nigga to say, I'm going to raise money for Follows America and all this, and then just take the money and just say, fuck y'all. It's nothing for a nigga like that. He was born into deception. He was born from deception. That's a hell of a thing, dude. Look, I've been around a lot of grimy niggas. And it's always niggas who grew up in shit like that. When you come from deception, a deceptive ass relationship, that shit is in your DNA now, dude. It's hard to shake that out. Nobody's saying it's his mom's fault. I'm not saying anything is anybody's fault. Yeah. He's doing good. Eric is doing good. Oh, that's another thing. That Sodom, his brother said that Sodomia shit, that's some made up shit. This nigga ain't Panamanian. All that shit, his brother, this is, ain't no, all that shit about he from Panama, his dad ain't from no damn Panama. His brother told me that. His brother said, that nigga that made all that shit up, ain't no Sotomayor. That ain't his last name. His dad's name ain't no damn Sotomayor. Y'all nigga, I knew that even without talking to his brother. His brother, own brother said it. Ain't nobody in this nigga's family named Sotomayor. He's Panamanian. His brother said, Panamanian? That nigga's dad is from fucking Georgia. Sotomayor. This nigga just pulled a name and an identity out of his ass. What, is Panama from, is there a Panama in Georgia? He's from Panama, Georgia. This nigga ain't from no fucking Panama. Ain't no damn Panama in this nigga's family. His brother told me this. Yes, you know how niggas be wanting to be something else so bad. This nigga is not. Sometimes people, y'all gotta understand, when people lie, you like, why would this person lie? I guess he's telling the truth. Y'all just don't know how much of a fraud this nigga is. Ain't nobody's name Sotomayor in this nigga's family. This nigga's mama ain't named no Sotomayor. His biological dad is not named Sotomayor. Nobody in his family's name is Sotomayor. This is a name this nigga picked up somewhere because it kind of sounds like it might have a Spanish inflection to it. That's a name this nigga grabbed out of his ass. And he had to come up with a place, a Spanish place, where black motherfuckers like him, who's dark, can get away with the lie. You can't say you Dominican. You dig? You had to pick a place that was somewhat believable to kind of claim you got some Spanish in you. You dig? He's like, wait a minute, I'm too black to say I'm Dominican. Ain't nobody gonna believe that. Too black to say I'm Cuban. That ain't gonna work. So Panama. We'll go with Panama. That nigga's from Pana East Point. Panama. And y'all stupid ass niggas sending a motherfucker lying about being from Panama some money. They ain't from no Panama. Nigga's dad ain't nowhere near no Panama. And this is his brother telling me this. His own brother telling me this. That nigga's a fraud. What part of fraud don't y'all understand? He's an utter and complete fraud. What I just told y'all was true about his dad, who was married, had an affair with Crispy's mom and had his Crispy ass. Now this nigga hates women. This nigga hates his mom for having an affair and having him and depriving him of a family while his dad's married, got another family on this side of town. Ain't no damn Panama. That nigga's dad is in Georgia. Well, his dad died. Now his dad is dead, by the way. His dad died, but his dad was in Georgia. That nigga's from Georgia. Nigga's not from no damn Panama. That nigga's dad was from Georgia. Man. Okay, I don't know who you're talking about, Vital, and whoever you're talking about. And that's another thing. I deleted what you posted because that's another thing. Y'all stop trying to promote dusty niggas. Yeah, he was an oops nigga. Crispy, that nigga was a mistake. That nigga was a mistake. And he's been feeling that all of his life. They've always looked at that nigga as a mistake. And he's been feeling like that all of his life. That's where all that self-hate comes in. Yeah, Vital, don't promote random niggas here. That's another thing. Don't be like, hey, such and such has said something about you. Here's his website. Don't do that. Don't promote that dumb shit. Don't promote dumb nigga shit. He was just being disrespectful. You know, this dude just kept taking jabs, and then I had to destroy his career. Man. No, he's never been on my show. So he was a Motel 6 baby. That nigga was a hotel fuck. That's a hell of a thing. Nigga, you were born out of being a hotel nut. Nigga's dad was getting some nuts on the side. And then his ass just kind of popped up. That's a hell of a feeling. That's why all that. And he blames his mom. That's where all that hatred comes from. That nigga cannot stand his mother. That nigga was a Motel 6 baby. Man. See, he was born in the backseat of a Volvo. Hilarious. That nigga, he knows. That nigga's ashamed of his fucking mom, his family, his background. Now, this is what his brother's telling me. His brother's telling me all this shit about his ass. So now this nigga, when you ashamed of how you were brought into the world, you are born out of a damn affair, out of deception. So yeah, you gonna tell people some shit about Panama, some shit, a place you or nobody in your family's never been. Now you gonna make up some shit about Panama and... And dumb motherfucker, and not too, he don't have a big audience at all, but just the 5 or 10 people who do listen to him, I still look at you like, what the fuck? He ain't gonna show up to catch a fair one. Yeah, this nigga, he's 100% bitch made, dude. Man, who is this calling right now? We got somebody calling. What's up? Who's calling?
Hey, what's up, Tariq?
Hey, what's up? Who's this?
It's Bo from West Palm Beach.
Hey, Bo, how you doing, fam?
Oh, just chilling, man. Listen, I had a question for you. You were talking about Dick Gregory, man. That shit was funny as hell, man. I wonder what it's feel like, man, to know so many, you know, master teachers, you know what I mean?
Hey.
You know, so many of them.
Yeah. That's why I get them in the movies, man. I get them, and I know how to ask them shit so they don't go off, because Dick Gregory will go off. So, you know, he got a little hostile with me when we were doing Hidden Colors, but he was cool, though. He didn't go off like he did on Old Dude, but, you know, I'm cool as hell with Dick Gregory. I love him, and, you know, I got respect for all the elders, man. But thanks for the call, brother. All right. Mm. Oh yeah, that I heard somebody emailed me talking about Chris. Speaking of Crispy, talking about one of his, and I don't know, it might have been him, because that's another thing. With somebody trying to make it seem like he's more important than what it is, usually it's him trolling. And they were like, "Yeah, we're trying to boycott one of Crispy's national sponsors." And they sent me a link. I'm like, "What the fuck are you talking about?" it was some link of this nigga pretending that he was doing a commercial. This nigga don't have no sponsors. Okay. Y'all, again, don't know how much of a fraud. When this... When we say this nigga's a 100% fraud, we mean just that. Most of this nigga does, most of the things this nigga does is fraudulent. This nigga's now going around doing fake commercials pretending that he has sponsors. He's a fraud. Ain't no national company gonna hire this unknown fuck to sponsor something. Are you that stupid? This man is a complete fraud. He fakes his views, fakes his comments, fakes everything. Fakes his name, fakes his lifestyle, fake. Every fucking thing is a phony. It's nothing for this nigga though. This nigga came and was born out of deception. This nigga's whole life has been phony. What part of that don't you understand? We're going to hit national sponsors. Are you retarded? This nigga ain't got no damn sponsors. Nigga does commercials. Whatever, everybody. This is crispy. For Coca-Cola, everybody. Coca-Cola is so delicious, everybody. Let me stop, because I'm going to start getting more crispy puppet material. Whatever, everybody. Y'all giving me material. Hold on. Whatever, everybody. This is crispy for Massengill. You don't feel so fresh, everybody. You raggedy black bitches. Everything this nigga does is a fraud. God damn, what part of fraud don't you understand, man? Jimmy Fallon, really? He's a Jimmy Fallon. Really? What part of this nigga's a liar don't you understand? If a nigga's lied this much and y'all still believe whatever comes out this nigga's mouth, anything comes out this nigga's mouth and you believe it, shame on you. Man, let's see who we got on the phone. Hey, what's up? Who's calling?
Yeah.
Hey, man, what's up? Hey man, what's up? Who's calling? Is this Trey the Troll?
Hello? Nah.
Okay.
Tariq. No, can you hear me?
Yeah, who is this? What's your name, man? You sound like
this true.
True. You sound like Trey the Troll a little bit, brother.
Nah, I ain't trolling.
No, all right. What's up?
I have one question.
Go ahead, brother.
Did you see the the white kid, they got killed, and they locked the two black police up within 72 hours.
I'm glad you brought that up. I forgot about it. I want to talk about that right now. Thanks for the call, brother. I got to chop on game about that right now. Thank you, brother. Yeah, that's what I wanted to talk about. Down in Louisiana, there was a shootout. The cops were going after this guy, this white guy, and the white guy had his son in the car. His son was 6 years old, little white boy. And two cops were black, so they're trying to get after this dude. And the dude, I think he tried to back up on the two cops, and the cops opened fire. And the cops ended up killing the little boy, which is sad. That's not cool. I don't want to see any child killed. But nigga, where was all that Blue Lives Matter talk? They locked them cops up the next day. Nigga, all that Blue Lives Matter, all that shit went out the window. Oh, it wasn't no grand juries and prosecutors deciding if they gonna... Oh, Lord, no. They got them niggas in the next day. Oh, you didn't hear all that Cop Lives Matter then, did you? All those white supremacists that's going around talking about it ain't about race. If you didn't break the law. Oh, no. None of that. Oh, it was none of that protecting the cops' identity where people had to dig for Darren Wilson's information. His picture came out later. Most of y'all don't even know what the cop who shot Tamir Rice, most people don't even know what he looked like. They've been hiding his pictures. They prosecuted these dudes, these cops, in hours and then put their pictures out there and their names out there. None of those police unions are all rallying behind them. None of that shit. Oh, they're not blaming the dad, which if it was a black kid, they would have blamed his thug daddy. If it was a black kid who got shot, they would have blamed the dad. They would have been like, well, his dad shouldn't have been committing a crime. All that Blue Lives Matter talk went right out the window real fast, didn't it? When a white kid gets shot, you don't hear all that Blue Lives Matter. That Blue Lives Matter went out the window. And they didn't dare put that on the father. The father put his son at risk. The father put his son at risk. Nobody's blaming that dad. Nobody's blaming that dad at all. And another thing, too, when this cop out here who raped all those black women, from what I understand, he's alleged to have raped over 13 black women, from what I understand. Where are those white feminist groups? Where in the fuck are all those white feminist groups who were rolling and going in on Cosby, going in on Greg Hardy, because he was in a domestic violence situation with a white girl. He had a white girlfriend. And there was a domestic violence situation where she released pictures of her bruises. I think it was from like almost a year ago. And all they got all up in arms over that. All these white feminist groups are coming out. All the NFL should fire him and they should do this. And oh, they got a lot to say when black people, one black person commits an act of so-called domestic violence against a white person. But when a white cop rapes a number of women and then get an all-white jury, people get kind of quiet. Melanoid empowerment, family. It's all about melanoid empowerment. That's why you empower yourself, melanoid empowerment. And you get a code because the white supremacists, they have a code. And the code works for them. And that's the thing that gets them over. They immediately go into code mode. And I see black folks, and that's another thing. These white supremacists, they're real quiet about this cop that done raped these black women. You notice you don't hear shit from them? You don't hear nothing from a lot of people in the dominant society about this cop who done raped all these black women. You don't hear shit. You don't hear nothing, and that's part of the code. You never join up with black folks against a white person, no matter what they've done. No matter what they've done. But black folks, you don't understand that code. Black folks don't understand that code. When the white supremacists are throwing another black person under the bus, you right there with them. Yeah, that nigga, he fucked up. Cut that out. You don't say nothing either. That's part of the code. When the white supremacists are throwing somebody black under the bus, you don't help them. I don't help them. I never side with a white supremacist against a black person. I don't do that. I need to see more evidence. Just like you don't see nobody going after Zimmerman. Nobody's going after Zimmerman. Zimmerman is out here posting up pictures on vacation, posting up pictures on the beach with cigars. The white supremacists, they allow him to do that. But they got the Negroes always putting on their tap shoes for white mommy and white daddy. Yeah, and these so-called pretend black feminists, they're such an embarrassment. Y'all pretend black feminists are such a damn embarrassment, and you know who you are. I say pretend because most of these people on Twitter that you see who run their damn mouths, they're nothing but a bunch of pretend black feminists who are tools used by the white feminists. The white feminists, they've used these women over and over to sabotage things in the black community. And when it comes to speaking up for black issues, these same white feminists, they leave y'all in the dust. They don't say anything. They don't help you. They don't assist you. They don't do anything. They're silent. But y'all run lapping up after their asses whenever they say jump, because they're giving you a couple of crumbs and butter biscuits. How would you like us to spread the news about Daniel? Because you have women in your family. Give us a task. I spread through Instagram, but it's not enough. Now, Quasia, are you white? Are you a white person? I'm just trying to understand everything you're talking about, man. Oh, yeah, that whole Ebony magazine crew is a joke. That whole thing is a joke. Okay, you're melanoid. Okay. Well, so you're just like us. We're victims of white supremacy. So we have to, again, it's all about empowering ourselves. It's all about empowering ourselves. It's all about getting in the mindset of creating and supporting an economic base. It's all about creating and supporting an economic base. And again, to not be sidetracked by the janky nigga shit. Because what happens is we start talking about an economic base, and then you get a bunch of jive-ass people trying to jump up in the mix and con and swindle and do all this old stuff. And that's another thing, black folks. Let me talk to my black folks for a minute. This whole scheming, conning, hit a lick mentality, that's going to have to go. The Big Boy interview, I don't know. Possibly it might air this week. A lot of times they'll do an interview and then air it a week or a week later, a week or two later. And I think they're going to air it this week because I know they had a lot of stuff going on for Halloween last week. So I think they're going to air it this coming week. She did an article. Yes, I have read the Turner Diaries. I got that book upstairs. Yeah, that's another. You don't hear nothing about Jared from Subway, his little moist child molesting ass. Allegedly. Yeah, the University of Missouri, the football players' protest. I heard about that. I'm still getting more details about it, but I take my hat off to those brothers for being in solidarity with each other and standing up and saying, hey, we're not going to play. What's up? Yeah, NYC, the kid, I haven't heard back from her, so I've been waiting to hear back from her. I haven't heard anything, and I'm waiting to hear back from her. But, yeah, shout out to those brothers in Missouri who are standing up. They want somebody fired from the school there. So I shout out to them for standing up. So where do I stand on the Second Amendment? We got to understand, man, the Constitution is not enforced for us. Because they say, look, they talk about the Second Amendment, which is the right to bear arms. But they got the laws now. This is what they do. They got laws now where they can still deny you a gun based on race. Because now in the gun application, you specify race. Which you shouldn't have to do that. What the fuck does your race have to matter? If it matters. Unless it matters. So now, you know, you got to specify your race. And also, they can deny you a gun at the discretion of the gun seller. So if the gun seller says, okay, I don't feel like this person should have a gun, They can deny giving you a gun. So these laws, they got all these laws for us, really. These are laws to really prevent a lot of black people from getting guns. But if you can, definitely get you one. Because these white supremacists are arming themselves to the teeth. And they sit around waiting to protect themselves if society ever breaks down. If society ever breaks down, they sit around waiting. And y'all got a taste of what's happening with Katrina. If you want to see how shit's going to go down, if society ever breaks down, go take a look at what happened in Katrina. Those white supremacists down there were armed to the teeth, and you had a bunch of broke, begging, starving black folks out there. The white supremacists out there getting guns, and y'all out there getting shoes and flat screens. So that tells you right there how the shit is. You got to change your mentality, black folks. The nigga shit mentality has got to go. That shit's going to get you killed. That nigga shit gotta turn up, gotta floss mentality. Katrina, there was racial extermination going on in Katrina. The media is not going to tell you that. And I think I might do a whole documentary on that. I might have to do a whole documentary just breaking down the racial extermination that happened in Katrina. Because people need to know that shit. Because of white supremacy, Laza. Dude, they were down there in Hurricane Katrina picking black folks off. There's thousands of black prisoners that then disappeared. Nobody knows what happened to them during Katrina. Thousands of prisoners down there that disappeared in thin air. Don't nobody know what happened to them. This shit is so deep, man. I might have to do a documentary about Katrina. Just really breaking it down. Yeah, I would do an interview with Dr. Sebi. Yeah, I still rock with Dr. Sebi. I get his products. Can I do a reference sheet for all the hidden colors? Where there is a book... where's this book? There's a book for Hidden Colors 2 called, where is it? I had it up here that brother Anthony Browder put together. Where the hell is the book? I think it's called Hidden Secrets, something like that. But they got a reference guide for Hidden Colors. I had it on my desk. I don't know where it is right now. But again, a lot of this stuff is very easily accessible. You can Google the information that we give and get more information based on that. Where are my South Africa people at? Again, I'm going to be in South Africa at the end of this month. I wouldn't. I love Gus T. Renegade. Gus T. Renegade is the truth. But I'm going to be in South Africa at the end of this month. My South African people hit me up. All my people in Cape Town hit me up. I got a lot of people in Johannesburg. They've been telling me to come down to Johannesburg, but I'm not going to be in Johannesburg. I'm going to be in Cape Town. I'm going to be in Cape Town. I can't wait to get out there. I cannot wait to get out there to Cape Town. All my Cape Town people, y'all hit me up. info@TariqElite.com. info@TariqElite.com. But again, man, down there in Katrina, when everything was going down, the white supremacists, they had their food and they had their weapons stocked up. And black people got funneled into the dome down there. On TV begging for help, dying. All you saw were black people floating up and down the streets of New Orleans. Unprepared. And that's by design, because again, the white supremacists, they create a situation where you are constantly in survival mode. You're in survival mode all the time, so you don't have a chance to think for the future. So we gotta create an economic base where we can sit back and plan for the future instead of just being on the go to make the next dollar before we starve. We got to be on the go constantly, nonstop. We're thinking about eating that day. So you can't plan for the future because everything is in the moment. That's why, you know, some of the nigga shit is orchestrated by the white supremacy, because psychologically they create that. So when you get an opportunity to get a damn flat screen, you ain't thinking about the future. You like thinking about shit that I ain't never had. Where you got to start thinking about the future and what's going to be practical and how can you protect yourself. Yeah, that's another thing, man. If you're on the county, yeah, it's time to get off the county. And look, I understand, man. Look, the system of white supremacy creates economic deprivation. I get it. But we got to start figuring out ways to get off that county. This county is bullshit. If they're going to give us something, they should give reparations. That county is just something to sustain you long enough to keep your children as prison food. And they did a test run with the EBT shutdown like a year or so ago when they shut down the EBT cards. All hell broke loose when they shut them EBT cards down. That's a test run. So they know how to get you. They want to get you dependent on that county. They want to get you in survival mode. They want to funnel you into one central location. So if things go down, they can shut you down very easily. What the hell is this? Sitting on some gum or something? Hold on. What the hell is this? Like gum on my clothes? Oh, yeah, that was a test run with those EBT cards. Yeah, we know who H. Rap Brown is. We know who he is. Yeah, how many years did Ray Nagin, is it Ray Nagin? Hey, I always get his last name mixed up with the other Ray Hagin and Ray Nagin. I always get their last names mixed up. But the guy, the mayor of New Orleans, Ray Nagin, how many years did he get? They locked him up. 10 years. Ain't that a bitch? Ain't that a bitch? There was another guy in Birmingham, another mayor that they got. Is it Larry Lankford? Where are my Birmingham people? Somebody said 20 years. Somebody said 10 years. Terrell, where you get 20 years from? Yeah, Kwame out of Detroit. All these, you notice all these black mayors get all these long-ass jail sentences. Kwame wasn't doing shit that the white politicians wasn't doing. He just wasn't part of that old boys club. See, that's another trick bag. They got you, they'll bring you in and let you be a mayor and let you get all these kickbacks and all these campaign funds, which they call bribes when it's a black politician, and then let you go to jail. Like Jesse Jackson's son, they put him in jail. Yeah, they don't put these white politicians in jail like that. As if they ain't getting money from constituents for doing favors. That's what politics is. That's what it is. Larry Lankford. How many years did Larry Lankford get in Birmingham? They gave him a whole bunch of years. How many years he got? There. They threw the book at his ass. Larry Lankford got 15 years, yeah. All these black mayors, man, they'll put you in there and then they'll flip on you. They'll say, okay, well, you took a bribe. Well, how come the motherfucker who took the bribe or gave me the bribe ain't going to jail? What's up, Ola? Everybody say what's up to Ola. Ola's in the house. What's up, Ola? I got that package from you too, Ola. I got that package in the mail too for you, Ola. Ola, I might have you go to Toledo with me. This week, Ola, because I was going to go by myself, but I might have you go because I need to film that and I need you to be on top of everything. I've been meaning to call you, Ola. I've just been doing so much. Yeah, all these black mayors, man, they throwing the book at him. What even happened to Richard Arrington? Y'all remember Richard Arrington out of Birmingham? Shout out to me from your brother in France. What's up, Yaya from France? How you doing, brother? Yaya, can you speak English? You ought to call up, man. Let us know what's going on in France. Yeah, I got to watch Walking Dead in a minute. Yeah, Ola, I'm going to have to bring you out because I need to make sure everything is going to be everything out there. Oh, yeah, Ola's my dude. That's my right-hand man. Ola handles business. So whenever y'all at my lectures or whatever, you'll see either Sean or you see Ola really running stuff. Because usually I'm behind the scenes. So Ola does security too. Basically, if we need to whoop ass, Ola be there. Ola's like a little superhero. Me and Ola, we were in, where were we? We were in London, I think. And Ola, he's Nigerian, you know. But Ola has that Mandingo warrior blood. And we're in the subway and the elevator was broke. And we had to take the stairs. And it was like a long... And they warn you before you hit the stairs. They're like, hey, this is a long-ass flight of stairs. It says, hey, the staircase got about 200 steps. So you might want to wait for the elevator. They warn you before you go up these stairs. I'm like, fuck it. We got to go up these stairs. Nigga, Ola ran up them stairs in about 30 seconds. I'm walking up these stairs, nigga. I almost had a fucking heat stroke. It took me about 10 minutes to get to the top of them damn stairs. By the time I got there, Ola's ass up there eating a croissant. I'm like, ain't this a bitch? Say, Ola got that African jiu-jitsu. Yeah, Ola, he was in the eugenics. We had Ola do a love scene with an Asian woman. Ola got it in. Yeah, Ola be having an African hookup. Ola gave me some yohimbe. Some African yohimbe. It was like some yohimbe liquid. Hey man, take this. I said, because you know, yohimbe gives you energy and all this whole shit. And I took that. And nigga, I gave Peanut the business. That's why TJ was born 9 months later. That shit does stuff to your genitals that works magic. I'm like, damn. Nigga, he gave me that shit and TJ was born, nigga. Yeah, that yohimbe, he has some kind of yohimbe from somewhere. Nah, I don't smoke weed. I do not smoke weed. Yeah, that yohimbe is not no joke, man. That yohimbe is nothing to play with. And I don't know where he got this from. This was some strong-ass yohimbe, nigga. Yeah, you spelling it right. Yohimbe. That shit was strong as hell. Ola, where did you get that yohimbe from? That shit was strong as shit. That shit made me feel like I was on that narcotic, man. Yeah, it's like little droplets of it. It's not even a lot, man. You take like little droplets of that shit, and that shit does all types of crazy shit to you, man. I took that shit and I was like this. I wanna get high. Man. That's Nigerian beat. Yes, indeed. But man, hey, the new shirts right here. These are the new shirts called Crucifixion. We got them in black and brown. Don't forget to get them at TariqElite.com. Don't forget to get them at TariqElite.com. That's the brand new shirts. You don't want to miss that. It's on sale right now. Real nice look. Dude. Thank you very much. A lot of folks love this shirt. And the shirt is real, it's very affordable too. It's less than 25 bucks. So it's less than a bag of good weed. It's less than a bag of good weed to get this shirt. And this shirt makes a statement. Because this is all of us right now. We're being crucified for the religion of white supremacy. So we need to acknowledge that. And let it be known and not play games and pretend that we live in a system other than white supremacy. I gotta see what we have in stock. I know a lot of those shirts go, like the RBG shirts. I know we got some gold ones left. The black ones just flew off the shelves. I mean, those shits flew off the shelves. What did Yaya say? What you're learning English with free apps on the Mac in. There you go, Yaya. Y'all, Yaya, how long you been living in France, brother? And what part of France are you in? I got to get back out there to Paris, man. I had a great time when I was in France. We got a few of the Tariq Elite jackets in the smaller sizes. I got some more coming out probably by Christmas. I'll keep you guys posted on that. But we got the smaller Tariq Elite jackets available now. You're born and raised in Paris. Okay, Yaya. Yaya, can you call up right now, brother? Can you call in right now, Yaya? We'd like to have you tell us what's going on out there in Paris right now. I know your English is a little funny style, probably. Because I've done interviews with cats out there in France and I don't know what the fuck they were saying. She said Morgan from Walking Dead be taking the Yohimbe. Now I'm telling you, take that Yohimbe. You take that, nigga. And nigga, you're going to be knocking your ladies back out. You can't call up Yaya. Now, Yaya, is your family from Africa? Where's your family from originally, Yaya? Just making sure you're on the up and up, that's all. And what do you do out there, Yaya? You from ATL? From the Ivory Coast, that's what's up. Yaya, have you been to the Louvre out there? Because when I was staying out there in Paris, I was staying at the Louvre Hotel. I was literally at a hotel right behind the Louvre. The Louvre is a very well-known museum out there in Paris. So if you ever go to Paris, you definitely have to go to the Louvre Museum. They got all our African shit up in there. All our African shit is up in there, dude. You go down, and they got it down deep in the basement. They got all those black statues from Kemet. They got all that shit at the Louvre, man. But I love Paris, man. Paris is a cool, smooth-ass city. I absolutely had a great time out there. It's called Yohimbe. That's the name of it. Oh, 15 minutes by car. There you go. And Yaya, have you been to the Versailles Palace? Have you been to Versailles, the Palace of Versailles? That's another thing, too. There's a palace out there called the Versailles Palace. And nigga, I think Louis the Eighth, which one? Louis, one of the Louis out there owned it. And the Versailles Palace, Louis the 13th, one of those Louis. I forgot which one it was. There's so many Louis. And the Versailles Palace, man, that's some baller ass shit. It's this big ass palace that this king built out there. And this shit is huge. This was a motherfucker's house. This shit was tight as hell. Yeah, yeah. Africa. Again, I'm going to be in South Africa later on this month. And in next year, I'm going to hit up more spots in Africa, too. So Yaya, I think Yaya's on the up and up. I hope he's not trolling. I think Yaya's on the open up and up because I do have a lot of listeners worldwide. So where do you get the Yohimbe from? Where can you get it from? Places like GMC, you might be able to get it from there. I wonder, does Tahuti have the Yohimbe, Ola? I ordered some stuff, and I live by Tahuti stuff. What's Tahuti's website? Is it D Herbs Health Store or something like that? What's his site? You know what? I got his products right here. D Health Store. Hold on. What's his website? Okay, the website ain't on here, but this is some of Tahuti's products. D Health Store. I live by Tahuti stuff. I got some stuff for my children. I got some, speaking of those liquid drops, I got my, because my kids were sick the other day. And I wanted to find something that was, that I could give them that wasn't too strong because, you know, my kids are two and under. And Tahuti told me to get, he had, what's the name of it? Some kind of immunity drops that kids could take. I gave it to my kids and bam. The next day, they're fine. The next day. I mean, his shit works like that, man, overnight. Yeah, Tahuti stuff is no joke, man. My wife, she got sick. I gave her some of them immunity pills. Bam. Within hours, her shit was fly. She was good. Shout out to Hot Double Diva. She, you know what, Hot Double Diva, I've been meaning to call you. She hit me up. She wanted me to call her, and I've been running around. I totally forgot. But she's still around. Hot Double Diva is still around. So I wonder if Tahuti, I think he might have something with that Yohimbe in it. I think that Jackrabbit formula has Yohimbe in it. So you have to see his website because, you know, Tahuti has all the real deal stuff. There's another place in Brooklyn, not Brooklyn, in the Bronx that has something too, that has some real good stuff too. I can't think of the name of these. I got their flyer upstairs, though. It's upstairs. Next time, please remind me to talk about this stuff that these people have. They got some stuff. This brother has some stuff that's almost like Yohimbe. It's called Man Back Drink. It's like some shit that this, it's a big ass bottle they send you. And that shit is like Yohimbe too. It's as strong as Yohimbe. And it's a place in the Bronx. It's Rasta type brother makes this stuff. He gets a lot of African herbs and all that. That's what I want to do when I get to Africa. I want to get all those herbs and all that shit when I get back out there. Man back from Jamaica. Yeah, I think the dude is Jamaican who makes that stuff. And I know he's in the Bronx. Oh yeah, Haiti has a lot of potential, man. But with Haiti, I was going to get Dahoudi, but because of time constraints, I didn't get him in Hidden Colors 4 yet. I really wanted to, but because of the time constraints, I didn't get a chance to do it. But my man was talking about Haiti having a lot of potential. It does have a lot of potential. It does have a lot of potential. But again, the white supremacists, you have to understand, they created a lot of sanctions to specifically starve Haiti out, to punish Haiti for getting their independence. It was. Oh, yeah, yeah. They specifically targeted Haiti to sabotage the growth and the progress. All right, yo, let me get out of here. I got to go watch some of these shows, family. I'm out of here right now, family. I'm